Hello guys, welcome to another episode of Bangkok Chili Peppers TV. I am Muda and in this episode I will bring you back to North Bay. Let's go!
This is part 1 of my 13 days adventure in mid-March in Northern Norway, Arctic Circle. I will explore Tromsø, the Lofoten Islands, a quick stop to Alta and then reach the North Cape, the northernmost point in Europe that can be accessed by car. I will give you a lot of tips, show you amazing places, great food and northern lights. If you decide to travel in northern Norway during winter like me, be aware that snowstorms may condition a lot your itinerary. Drive carefully, install the application YR to check the weather forecast and plan accordingly. So be ready and let's go!
My journey starts in Tromsø, but let me tell you more about this city.
Tromsø is the place where I landed in northern Norway. Here I will spend 3 nights. This city is located at 350 kilometers north of the Arctic Circle and has a population of around 80,000. Due to its position, it is a great place to enjoy the midnight sun and also the northern lights, especially if driving outside the city. The city center, characterized by historical wooden houses, is built on the island of Tromsøya. It's easy to explore by just walking. I will now show you the main points of interest. Storgata is Tromsø main pedestrian street, packed with cafes, restaurants and shops.
And there is also the 7-Eleven.
It's crazy, the weather changes so often. The Tromsø Cathedral was built in 1861 and is the only Norwegian cathedral made of wood. Polaria is the name of the Tromsø Aquarium. My top picks for museums are the Polar Museum that provides details of the history of Tromsø and the Arctic, and the Arctic University Museum that I found much more interesting. Here you can understand the evolution and adaptation of animals in the northern regions, the Northern Lights phenomenon, and there is also an interesting exhibition that explains the history of the Sami. This population have for centuries, even today, been the subject of discrimination and abuse by the dominant cultures in the Nordic countries they have historically inhabited. Skansen is the oldest building in Tromsø, from around 1790. The Tromsø Bridge opened in 1960 and connects Tromsøya with Tromsdalen, the area where the Arctic Cathedral is located. It's the main subject of the city skyline and opened in 1965. It houses also concerts. The cold does not stop people here. There is who cycle and even run. Near the Arctic Cathedral is located the Fjellheisen. This cable car is open until late night and will bring you in around 5 minutes up to the mountain Sturlsteinen at 421 meters above the sea level.
The view from here is spectacular.
Here is the starting point for the hike to Fløya and the Tromsø's highest peak, Tromsdalstien, 1238 meters above the sea level. Hike during summertime is a common activity in Tromsø, but during winter it can be very dangerous. This place is also a popular destination for snowshoeing and to enjoy the midnight sun or even the northern lights in case of very good weather condition. There is also a restaurant to enjoy dining above the clouds. With a short bus ride, I reached the lake Presvanet, near the airport. Skiing is very popular here.
The lake is completely frozen. I think that this place will be completely different in summertime.
Let's go back to the city center.
Today the weather is horrible. Better go to eat something.
I will now show you my favorite restaurants in Tromsø. Graffi Grill has a cozy atmosphere and good meat. Norway has a strong beer culture. I ordered a Nordlands local pils and chopped steak. It looks delicious.
Lovely.
You should try the fish in Tromsø. Fiske Compagnie is a great choice. It's a little bit expensive, but quality is high. Let's start with a glass of Graffi Norwegian beer and grilled beets with smoked haddock and botarga.
Delicious.
Now Arctic char with salsify, sour cream and dill. It's so delicate, strongly recommended. Norway has excellent sushi. This country is the number one salmon exporter in the world. From here the fresh salmon arrives even to Japan. Raw sushi is my favorite place to enjoy a miso soup and a lovely sushi selection. The view from here is amazing. My favorite place to drink at night is Olalen. It has a great selection of beer and ciders. A new day started and I decided to rent a car to explore the island of Kvaløya on the west side of Tromsø. The landscape here is very dramatic.
It's a really beautiful drive over here.
This area is popular for camping, hike, ski, snowboard and to enjoy the midnight sun. It offers also several great locations to admire the northern lights because far from the city light pollution. I am driving to Grotfjord, popular swimming destination in summer. During the autumn and winter season, there are often good surfing conditions. From Grotfjord I will drive to Tromvik. This road is very windy, I recommend you to drive here only if the weather is good. Tromvik is a small fishing village. Colored wooden houses are very popular in Norway because they are well visible even with a lot of snow. I just passed Ashfjord Bottom, a small village 20 km far from Tromsø. I am driving to the south part of Kvaløya to then reach Sommarøy.
This place is really a must see.
Sommarøy is an old fishing village spread across several islands. Main sources of income are tourism and fishing. This bridge offers a great view of the mountains of Kvaløya and Senja. Here the sun does not set from 18th of May to 26th of July, a full 69 days. This is then followed by long polar nights from November to January when the sun does not rise at all due to the location north of the Arctic Circle. For this reason, in the past, 350 inhabitants of this island were campaigning to be declared the world's first time free zone. The campaign was saying that here is normal to cut the lawn at 4 a.m. or take a coffee on the beach at 2 a.m. Tourism officials suspected that the campaign was just used to attract more visitors during summer. I am now driving to Kvaløyvågen, another fishing village. It's almost evening and I want to find some good spots, hoping to be able to see the northern lights tonight.
I decided to come here in advance. Upfront preparation is key for success. And here we are, this night is incredible. Oh, I'm freezing, shooting the northern light is not so easy.
The first part of this adventure is over. If you enjoyed, smash the like button and subscribe to this channel where you will find part 2. See you soon. Bye!